Alleluia, the kingdom of God is dwelling with men.
Blessings of God is sufficient. Open your heart, receive your blessings. Blessings of God is sufficient. Open your heart, receive your blessings.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. The kingdom of God is dwelling with men.
Let all the earth on bended knees, the Spirit of God is working in you. Let all the earth on bended knees, the Spirit of God is working in you.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. The kingdom of God is dwelling with men.
Okay, it's a pleasure having you once again to this very most interesting and most exciting program called The Hidden Manna. I always like telling you that this program is a program for seekers of knowledge, those that want to have knowledge, those that want God to open, to clear their foresight and to see what actually the kingdom of God is, what it looks like, and who is God, where is God, where does he reside, how is God, and everything about God and the kingdom of God, including that of the kingdom of darkness. It will surprise you to say, why did I say the kingdom of darkness? Because if you don't know the kingdom of darkness, how will you differentiate the kingdom of darkness from the kingdom of light? So this program is one of those programs that will teach you and to elevate you and bring to your knowledge the ways of God. You're welcome to the program, The Hidden Manna. My name is Good News Samuel Peter, and don't worry, you have your regular guest here with you in the program today. That's His Grace Archbishop Romel Emenike. Good day, sir.
Thank you very much for having me.
Yeah, how have you been doing?
Been doing good. Thank you, Father's grace must always survive by His grace. And we cannot be lacking
at all, you know,
because we have Him.
He's
everything. Having Him means having everything in the name and power of Serena Sulumbo
Lumbo. Amen. We want to thank the Father for this program. The program has been having series of feedbacks, and even when we appear live on other programs, the Father has been doing His work on this program. I don't know if personally you've got some feedbacks and people reaching back to you to encourage you to keep up the good work. I would want to use just 5 minutes to thank them for watching the program.
Yes, yes. Yeah, as you can see, the program, as the Father may have it, is very tantalizing. So a lot of people are eager, you know. First would have so far dominated the space, and like one woman sent a reaction which I read before the Father the other day. The woman says, we thank the Father, that she thanks the Father for this program, that it has provided a breath of fresh air.
Fresh air.
Yes. So for somebody to, you know, voluntarily, you know, type such a message and send it, meaning that the message really has made impact. And of course, when you look at our morning breakfast, the live one, you see people calling enthusiastically, wanting to know, you know, more things. Most of them were also wishing that, you know, we, you know, prolong the timing,
the time,
you know, the timing.
Program.
You know, so because when something becomes interesting to hear, then most people who love the truth will always want it to happen over and over again.
I call them seekers of knowledge.
Yes.
Those are seek knowledge. Okay, you've heard from our host on the program. Personally, I want to thank you all for the feedbacks and those of you encouraging us to do to go about this program. The program is also open for sponsorship. If you were led by the Spirit to also sponsor the program, you can contact us, and so that the Father will also continue to bless you in the name of our Lord, His Holiness, Olumba Olumba Ogo. All right, today on the program, we also have yet another interesting topic. Some people will be wondering, do they want to continue with reincarnation? Maybe a part four of reincarnation. But don't worry, maybe in the course of the program, if there's need that we have to come back to any of the topics that have been, you know, projected, maybe for clarity or because of demand that people want it to be, you know, expatiated, to be, you know, elaborated more, no problem, we still have to come back to them. But today we have yet another very interesting one that might, we don't know, depending on the discussion today, might have a part two or it ends here, but it is very, very interesting and it's going to be a mouth-watering topic. So sit tight, just in case you don't have a popcorn, you can get a popcorn, sit down and start enjoying the program. Today, we want to be talking about the topic is the role of churches in satanic agenda. I know you said, yeah, that, of course, that's a tough one. The role of churches in satanic agenda. Okay, Your Grace, why did you select this topic? Why is it so important to discuss our churches and their roles in satanic agenda?
Good. In the name of His Holiness, Olumba Olumba Ogo.
Amen.
Now and forevermore.
Amen.
First, let me attend to your question, because it's a question why we chose this topic.
Yes.
Indeed, the topic was chosen due to the urgency of now.
Okay. Okay. The urgency of now.
Of now. Yes.
Okay,
this period, this season, Christ has come, and a lot of things are still happening. Are there? Souls are being, souls living in flesh. Deaths are occurring rapidly. And I know what is happening. It is ours, you know, to say it courageously and unequivocally. No matter whose ox is God, it is imperative that the way is being divulged to us by the Holy Spirit. We put it out that way so that people can be adequately sensitized. Like I've always maintained, we are not judging anybody, but devil had orchestrated a lot of lies. And we can see the bandwagon of, you know, a greater percentage of the inhabitants of the earth tilting towards his way by way of manipulation. Most of those people tilting those ways of the devil, you know, may not be conscious of where they are going.
They are going.
Yes, they are, I can bear them witness that they are largely not conscious of it. They are manipulated, given that when you are in the world, you see the norms of the world, you see things that are practiced in the world, then you decide to follow suit, most of which were orchestrated by our parents. Those ways that we told, you know, in life, we are ways orchestrated by our parents, and we came and, you know, joined the bandwagon without any form of research, without any form of encounter of the Holy Spirit that would have directed them, you know, appropriately. So that is now, you know, lies, concocted lies, manipulated lies, and everything, Father, that everything that has been done here on earth is targeted towards making man walk in darkness, especially as it has to do with this contemporary generation where God happens to be physically on earth with that kingdom which he promised. Yeah? So now, having come and established his kingdom, Satan now and his demonic angels and other gods within his sovereignty are now on rampage. All they are inventing, all they are, you know, concocting and concurring, all the things they are building, is manipulating, is all targeted towards making man not to, in any way, you know, look that way that God has established.
Recognize God.
Then the same them, you know, came to Nigeria here, made Brotherhood of the Cross of Sir, which is the kingdom of God that came from above, which is where everybody, every soul should jostle to be in order to be reformed, in order to be, you know, for our ways to be redirected and to conform with the standard of the judge, the Supreme Judge, who is seated on the throne of his father judging now, you know, so that we, you know, will conform with his ways and standard. That also would enable us to escape the judgment that is going on. And having worked with him, death is inevitable. Death is inevitable. I mean, the physical death of the flesh. So when you go, then you're like those who does not attain his level of purification, acceptable to return here. Then when they go, you know, that way, he will surgically, you know, in a liquid way. I call it liquid surgery. To surgically remove the entanglement of Satan, separate you, extricate you away from it, and make you independent of satanic influence. If there's any other influence that you must have, it should be that which will be inculcated, which will be put in you, you know, by the Holy Spirit. And then when you come, you can be in harmony with him. Okay. You can be in harmony with the following being. That's when you can have love, unquestionable love. Because the kind of love I see prevailing in the world is just kind of love, pretentious love to let me behave the way I have to behave to make them think I have love. No, this one is, you don't even know when you are doing it. As you are doing it, people will be thinking you are a fool. That is because Holy Spirit overwhelms you, you know, to manipulate you in order to conform with his standard. And that is only the standard that you must attain to enable him absorb you to be in his universal kingdom and to live forever. That is what to live forever means. Now this reality is going on. You know, the ship is sailing to its destination, and a lot of people, a lot of people, overwhelming percentage of the earth are out there, not even sensitized, not even aware of such a thing is going on. And guess what? The worst aspect of it is that there have been a lot of structures in the name of God, in the name of churches, established here and there. It, you know, to accommodate them, where they are made to walk in darkness, where everything that emanates from there in the name of teaching, in the name of gospel, all of them tantamount lies and you know, dipping them more into darkness. We're situation where what is prevailing in church now is pastors who, in their sophism, you see them, you know, very clever, speaks, you know, motivationally,
eloquently,
motivationally, all gearing towards promising them Christ will make them rich, when by this time and age, what is imperative, what is considered absolutely pertinent in life, it should be our soul, preservation of our soul, salvation of our soul, so that we can live forever. So now, the devil has given it priority and has established a structure called Pentecostal Church, emanating from America. I know consciously the origin of Pentecostal Church, the purpose and the essence.
Wow.
Yes, the origin, the purpose and the essence. Wow. It is traceable to Book of Revelation chapter 13. The role the Pentecostal Church has come to play. Now, prior to the evolution of Pentecostal Church in the early 60s, in the late 60s, yes, in America, what gave rise to it, I know, but let me first go to other churches before Pentecostal Church.
Okay.
The first church was Israel. The first church of God is Israel. Yeah, the first church of God is Israel.
Okay.
Now, their entanglement in Egyptian doctrine, Egyptian ways of life, occasioned by that 400 years enslavement in Egypt.
Okay.
The Egyptian darkness rubbed off greatly on them.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, when they were released from Egypt, headed to land of Canaan, it continued. It because you know why? Then paganism influence is overwhelming the earth. The influence of pagan overwhelms the earth so grievously that everything, as you speak now, even up to now, everything we speak that has evolved, that are in existence on earth, exists through the inspiration of, you know, the pagan world.
Okay.
Yes, that is why all we study, everything that we know in life, are tailored towards knowing counterfeited things. Science is counterfeited spirituality. Science is counterfeited spirituality. The reason is because they are determined, the principalities and powers of darkness, you know, who prevails here on earth, who foster, you know, who brings to bear all those satanic inventions, productions. Yeah, they are determined that you do not understand what prevails in their world. You do not pierce this veil between the physical and the in the spiritual to be conscious of spiritual things. Because by so doing, if you are allowed to develop so that then it establishes their modus operandi, their characteristics and everything they are made of, it exposes them. Except those who are initiates, those that are permitted to be conscious of what obtains in their kingdom. And being an initiate means that you are part and parcel of what they do. So now, the Church of Odys Israel. That is why you see, even Babylon, they will always go to carry Israel captive. People should have paused and pondered, what is it that every kingdom, every pagan kingdom will always want Israel to serve in their kingdom? Like in the case of Egypt. Egypt brought Israel, you know, compelled them to serve in their kingdom of slavery. The same way with Babylon. The thing is that there is a light in Israel. There is a particular light, not this light of sun. The light that energizes the world and the practitioners of pagan. The light where they thrive with their power emanates from the sun. The deity they serve is the feminine deity, is in the sun. That same deity is occupied in the sun. Yeah, that is where that deity lives. And that is why you see in many flags of this world, many nation flags, you see either they use red or yellow to indicate the radiance of sun. Yes. Now, that means that it is this sun the world worship. In churches, in their shrines, in secret society, in everything that has to do with religion, that require you worshiping a god, it is this sun that the world worship. Yes, and that is why if you look at the flag of Argentina, Argentina flag, is the middle has a sun in it. And not just the sun, there is a feminine face, a woman face,
going in the sun,
a woman face. That is how Argentina flag is. That is, you know, they've demonstrated the image, the feminine image of the deity that radiates, you know, a satanic light onto the world and uses to rule the world. Now, the first church was Israel. Then the second church was the one the Lord Jesus Christ established. That is the second one. Our Lord Jesus Christ established, which is still Israel. But by then, it was not supposed to be limited to only Israel. It was supposed to be all over the world. That's why he commanded them to go into all over the world. Because by which time Israel had migrated and dominated all over the world. And also Edom is also a component of God's kingdom. Edom, yeah. So, and for the pagan influence that has been rooted in Israel's people, that gave the impetus for, he didn't reject Israel. It's just that their mistake, you know, their crime was what led to God, you know, extending his fatherhood, you know, onto all other part of the world. Like the Edomites, you know, to mention precisely, Edomites, yeah? Esau and Jacob, the father of Lungo Lungo, has whispered to me that they are one person spiritually. Yes, Esau and Jacob are one person. Yes, it's just that.
But they are two, they are brothers?
They are one person, the soul. The soul is one soul.
Okay.
Yes, what happens is that when they come that way as twins, darkness will choose one. God will choose one. That is why he said, Esau I hate, Jacob I love. What is the crime of Esau? It's just that he has been chosen by darkness. Yes. And he immediately chooses you. God, he's not hating the soul. He hates the spirit that manipulates you, that is in you, that, you know, uses you to behave the way that God dislikes. That is what it meant. Not that the soul is the same one person. Yes, the same person.
But it's actually the spirit that has manipulated you at that point.
The spirit that has possessed. Use the word possessed so that the people will know what he actually is saying. People that possess this, because that spirit is anti-God.
Okay.
And just as anti-God, that's also God hate it.
Okay.
So that is how. Now, That is the second church. Was that time our Lord Jesus Christ came, after he left, his apostles and disciples, you know, went down and they gathered a lot of people on earth. That's the second church. That second church was hijacked in the days of Roman Empire, when Emperor Constantine, the pagan world has targeted so much to hijack the Church of God, having been established by the virtue of the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and the works of his followers. So the pagan world now started to re-strategize. There is a deep aspect of it, but let's take it, you know, this peripherally. A time will come when we'll go to the depth, when Satan, the pagan god, the feminine god, hijacked the authority of Israel. Yes, after Solomon. Yes, after the advent of Solomon.
Okay.
That is when they started manipulating to castrate, to steal the authority of Israel. And having stolen, they actually got it.
Okay.
They actually got that authority.
Mm.
Now, when they got that authority, when they effectively used it, became in Rome.
Okay, yeah.
So, became in Rome.
Mm.
Now, in Rome, Satan, which is this song, manipulated and inspired Emperor Constantine, who was a champion in the pagan, you know, practices. Emperor Constantine, the principalities and powers of darkness that rules this world, the sun, now manipulated Constantine to pretentiously join Christianity. The reason is because they had done everything during the time of Emperor Nero, Emperor Justin, a lot of emperors. They did all sorts of things to exterminate Christianity, to wipe them out. That is after Christ has come and gone.
Yes.
They multiplied in Europe because Peter, James, John, all most of them were preaching in Europe, in Rome.
Mm.
So they won a lot of souls. They won a lot of souls. And they keep evolving. As they kill them, they evolve. So what they did was to re-strategize the pagan world, the world of Satan, re-strategize to adopt another pattern. In which case, the emperor now have to pretentiously, in quote that word, he didn't join sincerely, that he has a genuinely repented soul.
Okay.
He pretentiously, you know,
joined
by way of manipulating the church. So when he joined, all the pagans in Europe, all of them, given that the emperor has been converted to Christianity, everybody, all the officials, all the senators, all the governors, all the administrators, all of them joined Christianity. They didn't join Christianity with intention of genuine repentance. Rather, it was a manipulation carried out by their mother, Mother Earth, you know, to create that bandwagon that will lead everybody in Europe to Christianity. And when they went there, with all their doctrines and dogmas, all the pagan antiquities, all the practices, all the ritual, everything that they understand in their allegories, they all brought them to bear inside the church. That was when the very first time Satan infiltrated inside the church. It did not end there. Now, in AD, this infiltration by Constantine happened in AD 603.
Okay.
Sorry,
306.
306. AD 306. Now, after that bandwagon, all that trooping into the church had happened, they now hijacked the church. They determined what happened to the church. They brought all their laws, all their doctrines, all their dogmas, all their practices, all their rituals, everything, ceremonies into the church. That was what informed the doctrine of Catholic Church, where a woman is being worshipped. Forget that thing they tell you the maid is being honored. It is just counterfeit. What they did was their mother, who they worship, who splashes them with wealth, because you see, like I have always said in other episodes, God has anointed and appointed the woman to occupy the position of materialism.
Okay.
Yes, in every family, in every setting, it is the woman's spirit that is usually instrumentalized in the impartation of blessings, material blessings on a family.
Mm.
Yeah. So that is a position a woman reserves before God. That is why too, in his household, you can imagine on manifestation, he gave that to a woman. While the duration of when she possessed it were yet current.
Okay.
What I mean, listen. When there was tussle for supremacy, who will possess tight balls between Judas and Peter? Peter actually is the one anointed and authorized, you know, that has always taken custody of the word of Israel.
Okay.
Yes, that is his position. But as timing may have it, 2,000 years has not elapsed. 2,000 years has not elapsed. By that then, that the Judas, he revealed to Judas, that was the currency. That was the currency of the control of resources of the world by the kingdom of darkness. That is why the one who represented the kingdom of darkness, God gave it to him, being Judas. Yes, God gave it to him to take custody of, because he reserved that position before God. Because that is why when they brought coins to say it is good to pay, when they say is it good to pay tithe, to pay tax, when they went to ask him, is it good to pay tax, he asked them for a coin. They brought a coin. He said, whose face is in this coin? He says, Caesar. He said, give Caesar what is Caesar's and give God what is God's.
Okay.
What that means is that Caesar was still the head of the world, inventing things, the spirit in him, the spirit of Antichrist in him, the spirit of Mother Earth, was what Caesar used in inventing all the things that, so it is Caesar's. So give it back to him. Yeah, so now that is what he, by way of allegory, that is what he did by removing that earthly treasure,
okay,
which Judas, Peter was in custody of. He removed it because it is not yet time for him to possess it. So what he did was to remove it and give to the spirit that is being represented by Judas. That's what he did by allegory. Now, from when he established the kingdom, in 1930 something, when he established this kingdom, as they reassembled, what he did was to give it to Queen Mother. He gave it to Queen Mother, because as at that time, darkness was still in possession of that resources.
Okay.
So it has not. So that is why when he clocked 1999 to year 2000, he removed it from her and gave back to the King of Heaven.
Wow.
So who will now give it to people like all of you, according to promise that he has made 2,000 years ago. So
now when he comes back, those of you that have left
mother, he shall be received in a millionfold. On top of that, with eternal life. Bam. So I don't know what somebody should be doing elsewhere. When the thing you're looking for, you can get it here and at the same time get internal life.
Yeah.
So it's beneficial. I thank God for helping us to complete the sentence.
Yes.
So now, the second church, it became this particular one I'm talking about, where Constantine infiltrated and paganism hijacked it. Then successive pope who came by that infiltration, like I said earlier, happened AD
306.
Now, by AD 476, Catholic Church had risen so powerfully in the global stage where, you know, the Pope was assuming absolute power,
okay,
ecclesiastic power, political power, monarchical power, and the absolute power, the whole of Europe, where he now became a rallying point. Successive popes. The first pope ever to assume that throne, his name is Pope Julius. The first pope. Pope Julius the First. Because on assumption of throne, the last Roman emperor called Justin was mandated by Mother Earth to proclaim Pope Julius the head of what they then call Holy Roman Empire. They have constructed the first Roman Empire. Then was not conquered. There was no external conquest against them. There was no external conquest against the Roman Empire.
Okay.
Yes. In other words, Roman Empire was not conquered. Rather, it collapsed, it, you know, disintegrated within itself. Who are the Roman Empire? The Roman Empire is made up of 10 barbarian tribes. Ten barbarian tribes are the tribes that you call Europe today. Okay. Yeah, the Europe you know today, we are barbarian. Barbarian, there are 10 barbarian tribes who came together to form the then Roman Empire. Yeah, until when it collapsed. It didn't collapse that another force from, external force came to conquer them. They on their own, and on the margins of the Pope, they now receded to their individual tribal stock.
Okay.
Yes, they receded, they retired back to their individual tribal stock.
Okay.
They are the Germans. Mm-hmm. The Germans are the Alemanni. The Burgundians are the Swiss. The Burgundians are the Swiss. The Lampos are the Italians.
Okay.
Yes, the Saxons are the United Kingdom, the British are the British. Success. Then the French are France.
Okay.
French are France. Astragos, Slavi are the Portuguese. Slavi are the Portuguese. The Visigoths, are the Spanish. The Visigoths are the Spanish.
Spanish.
Now, this is seven. Then the Bandus, the Heruli, and the Astragos. These are the three barbarian tribes that pose resistance to the doctrines and dogmas of the pagan, having been infiltrated into the church. So with a strange doctrines and dogma.
Mm.
So when they came, these three tribes became very obstinate and in disagreement with the new norms of
trying,
the church,
trying to resist,
and pose resistance here and there.
Mm.
Now, what did Julius, the first pope, did? Julius ordered the emperor, because then all the emperors of Europe were under the pope. He appoints new emperors when there is a demise of a previous emperor. Yeah, he appoints a new emperor. So all of them takes instruction from him. So he ordered Emperor Justin, whom I said is the last
emperor,
yes, before the collapse. He ordered Pope Julius ordered Emperor Justin to go and extinct the three barbarian tribes out of the 10 of them, who are the Bandus, the Heruli, and the Astragos. They were extinct and no traces of any of their remaining bloodline now. That was what happened.
Wow.
So that is how Pope upon Pope upon Pope, until the last Pope was the one, Emperor Bonaparte, Napoleon Bonaparte of France, in 1798 was when Bonaparte, Emperor Bonaparte, sent Bathier, General Bathier, one of his generals, to go to Rome and remove the Pope. Pope was one, that's the last Pope, was one, you know, removed from office and overthrown. That happened. You know why Pope was overthrown? Because the energy, the light of the sun, the power that sustained that his sovereignty has relocated. Now, when Christopher Columbus in 15th century, 46 or thereabout, when Christopher Columbus embarked on a voyage mission to discover America, what happened then? You see, Christopher Columbus is an Italian from Rome, but lived in Spain. Yeah, when he embarked on that voyage mission, what happened there spiritually? What happened spiritually that people didn't know was the conveyance, the relocation of the stool of Antichrist, which was deposited in Rome before, and to relocate to America. That is why you can see the infrastructure of American buildings, like the Capitol Hill.
There's,
all of them are likened onto what you see, the buildings you see in Vatican City.
Vatican City.
The if you go behind White House, there's an obelisk. a tower. It's called an obelisk. That obelisk, if you measure it, it is, if you measure the size of the obelisk, it's 55.5 meters. Okay. Obelisk, the one in Vatican City, the one in Egypt, the one is wherever, that is wherever they are in the world. The standard measurement is 55.5 meters. Now, if you want to ascertain the connotation, the you know, what is hidden, you know it. Now, convert that 55.5 meters into inches. What you do, just by 55.5 times 12, 666.
Okay, let's take a break. We'll be back to discuss more. Remember, this story has taken us from Europe to America. We'll be right back to continue the role of churches in the satanic agenda. Please don't go away.
Simon Peter,
feed my sheep.
Oh, Simon Peter, feed, Simon, feed my sheep. Lovest thou me more than this? Feed my sheep, Simon Peter, feed, Simon, feed my sheep. Simon Peter, Simon, feed my sheep. Lovest thou me more than this? Feed my sheep. Simon, Simon, feed, Simon, feed my sheep.
Wow, you're welcome back to a very interesting segment of the, or a interesting episode rather, of the program The Hidden Manna. Today we're talking about the role of churches in satanic agenda. Now remember, whatever information and knowledge you've got here is divine knowledge as orchestrated by the Holy Spirit, and it is upon us to share it with you and to uplift your knowledge about God and His kingdom. Before the break, we were talking about some histories of churches, how the first, second, and where the churches are now. In fact, before the break, we were in America. We came down to America talking about the inches and the diameter of, what's it called again?
So, obliques.
Obliques, yes. Obliques. So, let us pick up from there.
Obliques. We'll come back to obliques later, but let's progress beyond where we were,
okay,
because it's a continuation of, you know, it's a you know, a continuation of a storyline.
Okay.
So now, when Christopher Columbus, like I had said earlier on, the voyage mission embarked upon by Christopher Columbus was a ritual, because when he was going, history has it that a lot of African slaves he took with him.
Okay.
When he got to Bermuda Triangle, he performed that ritual. That was the ritual that gave him the leverage and the leeway to navigate through the triangle, which is the reason why history holds that he happened to be the only person in history that has navigated through that triangle. It was because of that ritual. Yes, he did. He went there and deposited a lot of souls into the triangle, you know, to navigate through. So now, church from Rome, because when the Pope was removed from office, then started the Roman church started disintegrating.
Okay.
Then there became Anglican, Protestants, this, that. And church started evolving that in those ancient pattern and fashion. So now in the early 60s, remember, when you read Daniel, after the beast was removed from authority, that relocation to America was to manifest in another land. Remember, he started from his movement, started from Eastern Hemisphere of the world. The movement of the beast started from the Eastern Hemisphere of the world and to the Western Hemisphere, which is across the Atlantic Ocean. So he went there and situated himself to develop a very large empire and put out things that will enable him to distract the world. You know, instead of man thinking spiritual, man is thinking carnal, because in their quest to acquire, their zeal in acquisition of those things invented by Satan is what is going to contribute in dragging them, you know, far into carnality. And especially as it has to do with this time, this generation, when God has established himself on earth, established his kingdom, where what should matter, what should have been the order of the day, what we should be jostling for, is how to catch up with his standard. Now, it is the other way around, where we are now made to wallow and jostle for material things, which is taking us far into darkness. And guess what? We keep jostling for the material things. Satan and his people keep shifting goalposts, because he don't want you to get it, so that if you get it, he knows he will relax. He will relax.
Abandon him.
So he'll keep shifting goalposts. So that is
strategies.
So now, the church of now, Pentecostal, when Satan had relocated to America from Rome and institutionalized his government, which he called democracy. Pretentiously, because he comes like appearing simple, appearing honest, appearing genuine, appearing peaceful, but under the undertone is still blood, wickedness of the wicked, evil. Now, he has been strategized. Again, the other time was a government while he sits on the throne of God as a pope and rule the world for 1,200 and 3 score years. Okay. That is 1,260 years, as prescribed in the scripture. That is the duration of the reign of Antichrist here on earth. That's why Christ said, Antichrist, it is that his spirit is the spirit that will believe, that will make people think that God will not come in flesh. That is what the spirit would bring in John, 1 John. He said the spirit of Antichrist is such spirit that will make people think that God will not come in flesh. Any spirit that induces you to think that God doesn't come in flesh is the spirit of Antichrist. Because the spirit that wants you to wait in perpetuity and they keep waiting because he believes he will not come in flesh. So that's what he wonders. So that he should also, he went further to say, he said, be very careful of that spirit, because the spirit is already operating in the world. That was the Roman Empire, who doesn't want people, you know, to foster that understanding that God comes in flesh, so that the emperors will continue to exercise their dominion and control over them while they wait in perpetuity. You know, so it's the same spirit that makes the Jews, you know, not to believe in Christ. Because they have no understanding, or that he will come through the womb of a woman. They have no understanding. The Romans fought fiercely to ensure that nobody, that knowledge, they do it in the spirit to darken that knowledge. They also come in the physical, using certain organization to make it look non-existent, because that is the only authorized way.
Look like something very alien.
Alien.
Talk about God coming in flesh
and all that. So that is what the spirit of Antichrist, you know, does. So, but eventually, when the popes start assuming their successive popes, as assuming all in their offices, they on their own now, you know, return back to the understanding that when a particular entity, when a particular flesh is used at the end of his reign, the spirit possessed another flesh, which is what is happening now in Brotherhood that they kicked against. Yeah, you understand me? You know, because the father, when the father, the Ancient of Days has finished reigning, the Son, who is the Father, the Holy Spirit finished reigning and handed over to the Father. He's only not the Lumbo, but he's the Father. Now, when he finishes reigning, the Spirit also will possess the Prince of Heaven. Yes, because his own, he was going to grow and metamorphose into the Father. Then his own Son, that's why you see him. You see the Prince of Heaven. You see, people don't understand certain things. there are many, many things that have to be understood. It's not just come and think that see Father as God and it ends there. No, there are many things. Otherwise, if people have this consciousness of this characteristic that God, the light of God can depart, transform to another person, those are the ways the previous pope, successive previous popes, function. When they finish, that light of the sun, that light, the energy, the main energy that energizes and inspires the king, the pope, will possess another person. That's why they go to do ritual to ascertain a particular person that has been chosen by the light, by the sun. Because that is God, the sun, this sun. That's why you see them, the Holy Communion, they do, they breathe like this, is to symbolize their God, the sun. You go to their altars, you see the sign of sun. When they draw Alogius Christ, the fake Alogius Christ they have been showing to the world that is the man who died, that fake one. There are many faces of them, I don't even know the particular one. There's a ray of sun. There's a ray of sun. That in Holy Mary, in Jacob, Joseph, the father, there is a ray of sun. In little Christ, there is a ray of sun. So it is God. What they did was having caused Christianity to begin to follow their doctrines. By way of even the Christmas thing, Christmas, we know that Christ was born, comparing the duration of the pregnancy of the mother of John the Baptist. And by the time Christ's mother, Holy Mary, was conceived, by the time he put the calculations together, Christ is reportedly, reported to have been born in November. Either there are people who are saying 18th, but we know it's 20th. That was when Christ was born. What they did is, having hijacked the church, they begin to introduce their tradition, their way of life. Now the son, they worship their son. Now they now brought it into church and all that. Eventually, that became a norm that Christians now begin to follow and practice. The Sunday, we all know that God gave a day, which is Saturday. He called it a Sabbath day. That is why, too, in this time and age, He had sanctified that day and left it with the purest angels. Yes, the children. Yeah, we will go back to that day. What happened here that the Father followed suit to begin to worship on that same day? It has been declared by Christ Himself, Almighty God, He's in His authority, that He is a Lord and champion and greater than every other day. Right. Yes, that He can operate any day because all days belong to Him.
Yes.
Now that He said the Son of Man is the Lord over all the days. Yes, that's why. Now, because to having come, He has to institutionalize worship, His own worship that same day. Because, you see, when the saint congregates, when the saints gather, those whom He gather, in His eyes, they are like saints. When they gather, the vibration of the Holy Spirit in them, being that they are under His emblem, is going to whittle down the influence, the energy, the radiance and everything, all the negative things the other son emits in us. Let me also tell you another thing. You see, if you go to every church, all those ancient churches, they have pinnacles.
Yeah.
They have pinnacles. Pinnacles. Pinnacles.
Yeah.
That pinnacles is their own form of obelisk.
Okay.
You should have asked me, what does the obelisk do for them?
For that, yes.
Yeah.
What that do?
Obelisk is an antenna. Obelisk. It's an antenna. There is a universal energy called electromagnetic. It has largely, limitedly, positive components because it, in aggregate, came from photovoltaic energy, which is the energy, the light, the sun, the light that is behind our solar, our own solar system. The solar system in which the earth is situated is largely engulfed in darkness. That is why the gods there, the gods that in the interplay of gods, they are evil because they all operate in darkness. The life stream, you see, in form of light, are linked to human beings.
Okay.
Yes. Now, what happened when pyramid radiates the quantum of energy that is in measurement is 5.195 megahertz, very big. That is the one that sustains the earth. When it is captured from the atmosphere by the pyramid, then it is stepped down, through obliques. That's why every country, in strategic point, you see obliques in different sizes. You see just some monument tall like that. It may not be you know, shaped like the one of Egypt and the one of Washington behind the White House. But you see something tall like that, like a monument, that is obelisk. Okay. Many mythological tradition have their own form and pattern of obelisk. So obelisk steps down when energy is captured 5.195 megahertz from pyramid. When it is captured, then obelisk steps it down to the benefit of all the respective countries.
Okay.
Yes. When it steps down from obelisk, now they go down, stepping it further by the pinnacle. That is why you see in pinnacle, every pinnacle, the end of it is a cross. What is the meaning of cross? Prolonged suffering and pains. That is what that spirit they attract into the church and dispenses to the followers. That is why children of darkness tend to have more upper hand, more advantage over children of light in this earthly space.
Okay.
Yes. It is when they finish worshipping, when they finish worshipping, the energy that they are supplied with, with which they will make war against children of light in that community, in that village, in that town, in that environment, as members of those churches, is dark energy. That's why they symbolize cross. Their cross means it is the meaning of a thing, a spiritual meaning, a prophetic sign, symbol. What something symbolizes is what represents that thing. Because that thing there is suffering, pains. So the energy that it radiates and steps down onto the earth is useful to the people who possess dark energy too. They will use it because we are ignorant. We don't have to harness those energies. So it also went. They also went further to step it down into respective homes and houses. If you look at houses, they over time they made it a norm. They knock zinc. You see triangle. Zinc is shaped when you are roofing your house. They shape it like triangle. And in some American houses, European houses, you see, you know, in front of the house, you see triangular something looking like a fancy or decoration. But no, that is, they are also capturing energy. But you see, most people who do it ignorantly, fancy. That's why you see domestic violence and all sorts of things happening in the house, because they are radiating energy that they didn't know how to harness.
Wow.
Yes, that's why you see, you know, crisis in the house here and there. All the triangle they put and all of this, they are.
Some people will just think
it's not
engineering structural
No. Engineering thing.
Civil engineering.
Engineering thing were also copied from the traditions of Egypt. Architects and all of those things are evolved from them.
Okay.
So that is how they integrated all the disciplines and the components of things they need to know in order to manifest everything that tantamounts their doctrine and their way of life on earth. So that is how it has been happening. Now, as it relates to our time, why American church, America evolved the kind of church?
That's Pentecostal,
Pentecostal church. And guess what? I have been everywhere in America. I have been everywhere in Europe. I could not fathom a scenario where a church was invented, a thing was invented in America, and it is lacking. Largely lacking in America. You go to America, you don't see churches dominating the streets the way it is in Nigeria.
Okay.
Yeah? The thing is this. They invented it purposely to create a platform upon which they will, wage war against the truth. Against the knowledge which the Lamb is bringing to bear that establishes his identity, which is in the incarnation. So now, having established that church, that fashion and pattern of church or mode of worship, which is largely carnal from what you can see.
Yeah.
So what they do is, they are there only, they are representing our reincarnation of those people who chanted, "Crucify him, crucify him, let his blood be upon us and upon our children and upon our children's children." Now what happened is this: as the energy that brought, that vibrated to bring the manifestation of God here in Nigeria, the same vibration ignited the incarnation of those people who the priests, the scribes, the Pharisees, all of those people who opposed him before, all of them manifested in Nigeria.
Wow.
Yes, now listen.